And look at this now, both men going at it. The opening match in the first round. And look at this. Oh my God. You better watch yourself, Fantastico. You got to cover up. I mean, there's weapons all around the ringside area.
Wait a minute. I think they put our chair in the wrong place today,
man. I think
man.
They did. Look at this.
We're right up on the action here. This ain't right.
Sandman. Yes. Oh. Did you hear the impact? Did you hear the impact?
Right away, starting with the hardcore. Unbelievable. Here comes Sandman in our direction. Watch out.
And look at this. Right in front of us.
Klaus, you better be ready to move.
I am. I'm covering up. There's going to be blood spraying everywhere. Oh, look at this, right between the eyes. With that, well, you call them one of those bamboo tiki torches, if you will.
Yeah, but you know what? It's sharpened at the tip, and it can do lots of damage. Look at that.
Look at that, already cut wide open. Supreme busted open. The Sandman taking control, taking charge against the man that won the first ever XPW King of the Deathmatch tournament.
Now, remember, Chris, the history between these two, Supreme going all the way down to Cleveland to steal the belt away from
Sandman.
Unbelievable blow right there. Supreme stole the belt from Sandman, left him with a broken ankle. Sandman is angry, and I'm sure he wants to avenge the injury.
And you can't blame him for his anger, because Supreme, look at this. Look at this, the thumbtacks. Oh, this is sick, Fantastico. This is sick.
I have no idea what possessed Rob Black to do another deathmatch tournament. But you know what? If the first match is any indication of what the rest of the night is going to be like, we're in for a hell of a night.
And look at this now. The trash can on the head of Supreme and the flat nose shovel right to the trash can that was just draped right over the head of Supreme. And Supreme really taking a beating now from the Sandman here in the first round, the first match of the first round. Blow right to the head now. Look at that, hovering right over that light bulb. And what is this? A little, oh no, thumbtack paintbrush.
It's a thumbtack paint roller, that's right, Chris, watch out.
Sending now the original King of the Deathmatch into the ring. The Sandman going, oh, look at this, right on the face of Supreme. This is sick, Fantastico.
Niños, por favor, leave the room. Leave the room, this is very graphic. Not for your eyes.
And I noticed, Fantastico, you didn't join yourself in this tournament.
You know what? By the time I even heard about the Deathmatch tournament, it was all booked up. There was nothing I could do.
Yeah, right. I've heard it all before. And look at this. Look at the blood just pouring all out. And now it's Supreme. Supreme is fighting back. Forearms to the head of the Sandman. The Sandman now staggering across the ropes. Clothesline. Nope, not going to need the Sandman with a clothesline of his own. And Supreme goes crashing down. And you can hear the fans' disapproval of the Sandman. The fans really not taking a liking to this guy in this packed house tonight at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. Thousands on hand for the third annual King of the Deathmatch tournament and some other tournaments going on tonight. I can't remember.
Well, that'll be the tag team title tournament, Klaus.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
The finals, as we see Supreme's eyes being raked across that barbed wire.
Right now, the Sandman taking a little bit too much time, if you ask me. Look at this, what has he got now in hand? The Sandman with a shot, forearm shot. Fits right to the head, but no. Supreme blocking, and then once again, Supreme is fighting back, Fantastico. Supreme knows what it's like to be the King of the Deathmatch, and he wants to win this tournament more than anybody, I believe.
I believe Supreme was born, he feels he was born to be the King of the Deathmatch. The champion of the deathmatch, and he has proved it over and over again.
No, on the bed of nails, being utilized by Sandman with an elbow to the midsection, countering now. Supreme staggering back. And look at this now, Supreme thrown, yes, to the outside of the ring. And you gotta watch out. Once again, they're right in front of us. They are right in front of us. No, what is this? A little blow up, though? Looks like GQ Money.
Looks like a GQ Money piñata, man. Look at that.
I never thought I'd see GQ Money smaller than what he is.
You know what? You got a point there. I have to agree with you.
These light bulbs all around the ringside area, all the weaponry. And now, once again, both men inside of the ring. Irish whip coming up, reversal from Supreme. Oh, no, look at that. Trips him right in the middle of the ring. Beautiful move from Supreme.
That was a wrestling move that came out of nowhere, Klaus. He reversed the Irish whip and dropped to a toehold immediately.
Absolutely. And now it's another Irish whip coming up. Now another reversal from Supreme. Look at this, step over toehold and head first into the steel garbage can.
Well, this time it was Sandman's turn to feel that trash can. I mean, Supreme got a face full of that earlier with a bat. This time, the Sandman caught a face full of it. Flash.
And now look at this. It's that mini GQ mini money.
Excuse me, money. Mini GQ mini?
I never thought I'd see anything smaller than the real GQ money, but the artificial GQ money is much smaller. And look at this. The face being just raked across that bed of nails. And look at the face of the Sandman as he's busted wide open.
Now we have two bloody bastards in the ring.
Two bloody whoa. And now look at this. Once again, Supreme with the Sandman. Just right where he wants him. Another Irish whip coming up. Grab chest. Scoop up. Power slam. Oh, did you see that? The Impact Wantastico.
You know what? All I have to say is I wish that the guy that got slammed, I wish that was a real GQ money. I would have eliminated a bunch of our problems right off the bat right there.
Well, of course, the main event, that's a different story altogether. But look at this, Supreme going to the top rope. Supreme.
And look, Sandman can't kick out.
Look at this, mega toad splash, yes. Oh, 1, 2, it's over. Supreme advances in the tournament. And the Sandman. He's gone, eliminated. Supreme advances in the King of the Deathmatch tournament. Unbelievable, unbelievable. Vinny Massaro. And this guy is a surprise entry as far as I'm concerned for the Deathmatch tournament, but we're going to see what he's made of tonight.
Well, let me tell you something about the Soprano guy over here. I got nothing
it's
against
Massaro.
The Black
Massaro. Army. Massaro.
Whatever his name is, all right? Let me tell you something. I got nothing against the Black Army, but this guy right here, he learned. He learned in the ring. He learned in the ring. You see that? He learned in the ring that you can't mess with Pogo the Clown and Wantastico. That is why Vinny Massaro was forced to enter the Deathmatch tournament while Pogo and I are still in the tag team tournament. How do you like that? That's what I thought, Vinny.
Still the weapons all over the place, Wantastico. And yes, the Altar Boy.
Luke.
One half of the Altar Boy, Luke.
I believe this is Luke.
I believe it is as well. Look at the eyes.
He believes himself to be very, very righteous.
Indeed. Last time I saw him here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena, I thought I was at a Benny Hinn Revival concert.
At a what?
A Benny Hinn. You know, Paul and Jan, TBN, never mind. This guy has been preaching all over the world.
Introducing first, originally from Sicily, Italy, now residing in Las Vegas, Nevada, here is Sicily's favorite son, Vinny Massaro.
Vinny Massaro now being introduced.
And what Italians do you know with blonde hair?
His opponent from
Not
the
St. Many.
Mark's Cathedral, here is Altar Boy Lou.
You know, you gotta be really careful with these Altar Boys in the background in the locker room over there, because man, if they corner you, they will start preaching your ear off.
Well, they try to convert you.
They really do. I mean, I saw one of these guys talking to Kleinrock. He wasn't having it, though.
And look at this now, the second match of the first round. Armbringer now, from Luke now, onto Vinny Massaro. And then look at this, a reversal from Vinny Massaro into an armbar. And now look at this, snapper takeover, no, up and over, yes. Luke of the Altar Boys, leapfrog, up and over, off the ropes now, no. Oh, look at this, back body drop, no, reversed into a leg scissor, Hurricane Rana, and a beautiful takedown from Luke onto Vinny Massaro. Irish whip coming up, reversal now, from Massaro. To the far side, look at this, up and over, reverse DDT, beautifully executed from Luke. And these Altar Boys had shown me so much just in their last appearance here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena.
Unbelievable, these Altar Boys, watch this, innovative maneuver.
Oh, well, look at that, beautiful moonsault. One, two, only two.
From the outside in, I might add, never have I seen that before.
Beautiful standing dropkick from Luke of the Altar Boys. And this doesn't look like a death match so far, does it, Juan Tastico?
Not at all. But at any moment, the tide could turn. Shades of Rey Mysterio there.
Luke of the Altar Boys. Vinny Massaro now taking the low road out, it looks like.
And the Altar Boy giving a blessing to the people chanting his name right here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena as Vinny Massaro is on the apron. Oh, very smart move. Veteran move by Vinny Massaro.
Luke was going to use the leverage, pulling Massaro back in with that top rope, but it was Massaro quick on his feet. Look at this tornado spin of a... Oh, what a clothesline that was from Vinny Massaro. Just leveled Luke.
Shades of Pogo the Clown there.
Shades of Pogo indeed. We're going to be seeing a little bit later on in the XPW World Tag Team Title Tournament here tonight at Night of the Champions. And what a night this is going to be. What a night it's been so far. Belly to back suplex beautifully executed from Vinny Massaro. And look at this, another one. Look at this, two right in a row. You got to be kidding me. A percivalous amount of belly to back suplexes. Yes, three. No, oh, into a face buster.
Wow, Vinny Massaro with a plethora of maneuvers to take out the Altar Boy, Luke.
And this is very reminiscent of a classic XPW match, but it's not reminiscent yet so far at all of a death match. A tremendous match so far. Look at this, Luke, once again, getting on top of the sleeper hold, trying to keep Massaro in the center of the ring.
You know what, very smart move by a small guy.
Oh, sidewalk slam.
Wow, I was about to say that it was a very smart move for the smaller guy to try to knock the bigger guy off his feet with a sleeper hold. Massaro, though, the veteran that he is, turning it around into a sidewalk slam.
Beautifully executed from the man from Sicily, Italy. And now it's Massaro with the upper hand. Oh no, look at this, the bed of nails. No. Counter from Luke. Fist now to the head of Vinny Massaro. Irish whip coming up, yes. Reversal from Massaro, look at this. No, clothesline, duck underneath, and look at the speed of Luke. Oh, look at this, going to, yes. Another leg super, Hurricane Rana. And you can hear the approval of the fans here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena.
The fans really
Oh, into the bed of nails. Dropkick again, and he went crashing again, Massaro did. Look at this, Luke. Did you see the impact?
Vinny, face first. After the impact into the bed of nails, unbelievable.
Going for the pin now, Luke, one, two, only two, that was close.
These two guys putting on a beautiful, beautiful match. It is a death match, even though we haven't seen too much of the deathmatch tools implemented, but still a beautiful match nonetheless.
Look at this, Irish whip once again coming up. No, a beautiful baseball slide stop. Oh, look at this, double clothesline. None at all. Oh my goodness, did you see that suplex right into the bed of barbed wire?
His lower back and legs crashing into that barbed wire, unbelievable. The Altar Boy taking punishment. I don't know how Luke better pray for an escape
and
here.
And this could be it right here, one, two. Oh, how did he kick out of that? After that double underhook suplex, into the bed of barbed wire.
It must have been a miracle.
Well,
he must have been a miracle, Chris.
Do you really think that these guys
was always
the power
praying?
That...
What is this? Wait.
Oh, ooh. A kick to the midsection now. Counter from Luke and the Altar Boys. Off the ropes, clothesline. No, look at this. Double underhook. Oh!
I heard about this. That's a move. That's his move now. Vinny's other move. That's called the forget about it right there.
That's the forget about it.
Forget about
it. That's it right there. And forget about it. Because, oh my goodness. How did he kick out of it?
Vinny's in shock. Vinny's in shock.
So am I.
That was it. That was a forget about it.
I've never seen the forget about it executed ever. And he executed it beautifully. Now it looks like he's going for the belly to back. No, look at this. And it's Luke with the counter. And these fans taking a huge like a neck breaker. Luke now getting Massaro right where he wants him. Luke going upstairs. What do we have in mind here? Moonsault perhaps coming up. Twisting moonsault. Oh. Yes, it's over.
I think that's an upset.
Luke advancing in the tournament. Unbelievable. Over Vinny Massaro.
That's an upset.
History in the making, Chris Kloss. Wow, would you ever think we'd come to a time like this? At an occasion like this, where history, the first ever World Tag Team Champions?
Oh, look at this, Shady, a little shucking and jiving in there.
Shady is about to show everyone that he's not just some ordinary white vanilla rapper. As we get a quick two count, and we almost had an elimination.
And look at this now, Colin Abel tie-up, knee to the midsection. From K. Shabazz Malouk.
Now remember, anybody can tag in at any time, but when one team member is pinned, their whole team is eliminated. They need to return back home. Hook some DDT.
Beautiful DDT executed by Shady. Oh, look at this, a little break in two. Electric Boogaloo, I like to call it. One, two, only two once again. As K. Malik Shab Banana Milkshake kicks out. Oh, look at this, tag to Pogo. You gotta be kidding me. And now, I've never seen this look on the face from Shane Obelik, but Banana Blue Boo.
The look of what the hell are you talking about here?
Look at this now. And now Kay tags in Halloween of Mexico's Most Wanted. And now I see what these guys are made of. Because look at the fear in the eyes of the Panthers when Pogo got tagged in.
Well, Halloween with new extensions in his head, but does not impress the crazy psycho clown.
And look at it, you know, I heard that ring announcing earlier tonight. When the hell did you learn to speak German?
Let's just say a little gratuity goes a long way.
Well, whatever the hell that means. And look at this, scoop up. No, you gotta be kidding me. Halloween trying. Oh, look at this, Pogo now with a forearm to the back and a big scoop up now and plants. And plants Halloween right in the center of the ring. One, and
Chris Kloss, Pogo the Clown is not here to make any friends. He does not give a damn where the hell they're from or what kind of language they're speaking. He's never had XPW gold.
What a clothesline that was from Pogo onto Halloween.
Took Halloween's head off with that. Nobody, and I mean nobody, has a more lethal clothesline than the crazy psycho clown from Chicago.
Pogo the Clown, one of the most devastating clotheslines in the business. Pogo now going right after Halloween of Mexico's Most Wanted. Speaking of Mexico's Most Wanted, look at the teamwork. Damian 666 from the top waiting. High cross body, beautifully executed. Right on top of Pogo the Clown. One, two, only two.
Pogo's still fire. Tons of fire left. Firing Mexico's Most Wanted. Now a double team. Are we going to see a double suplex?
Oh my goodness.
Book vertical suplex.
I don't think I've ever seen Pogo the Clown handled like that, but by let alone one man.
One, Chris Kloss.
You got to do a lot to put Pogo away. And you know what? If Pogo's got to watch it because he is a big man, yes. He can go a long way. However, Pogo the Clown has got to watch it because he can lose his speed, his stamina in a hurry. That's where Juan Castigo comes in. And another devastating clothesline from the Killer Clown.
Almost taking Saeed Jihad off there. And we yet to see your running mate in the broadcast position. But we're about to see him tagged in for the first time. Is it going to happen?
Yes! Here it is! Ron Head, I feel like I'm at a robot convention when you talk. Look at this now. Elbow drop right to the chest of one of the black guys. Panthers. Look at this leg drop now from Juan Tazico, and Juan Tazico showing his stuff now as he did last month here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. Irish whip, yes, coming up. Drop kick. from Juan Tastico, and Juan Tastico now a house of fire, and he's the speed, he's the quickness of this team, as Polka the Clown getting a little bit of a respite outside on the apron.
Well, the new Black Panther's talking a lot of trash, and a Russian leg sweep from Juan Tastico. One, two.
That was close. That was very close. Shady.
Very close.
Shady, AWC, awaiting their turn in this match. As Black Panther member and Juan Tastico going at it. Irish whip coming up. Clothesline. No, duck underneath. Juan Tastico. Oh, and a huge heel kick right to the side of the face of Juan Tastico.
And Saeed nails him with that super kick, almost taking Juan Tastico's head off there. Hate to see his head come off.
This early. Look at that choke. That huge. Oh, look at that. Choke slam into a Michinoku driver kite maneuver. One, two, and oh, that was close.
Juan Tastico, I'll give him credit. He's got a lot of guts, a lot.
And here comes K. Malik Shabazz into the ring. Look at this now. Oh, look at that. Textbook suplex. No, into a beautiful face buster.
Sword buster, bomb hooks the leg. And chance of buckwheat as we get another two. Was that a three or not?
No, no. Juan Tastico just barely got that shoulder out of the way. And it was only a two count on both occasions. Now look at this. K. Malik Shabazz throwing Juan Tastico out onto the dirt. All the duck poo-poo here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena.
Well, Juan Tastico is basically out on his feet. And Pogo the Clown is getting the shovel wrapped in barbed wire. What happened?
Wait a minute. What is this? Juan Head, you should know. The referee eliminated. Juan Tastico.
Juan Tastico.
Oh, no. No. Look at this. Pogo. Pogo.
His partner. His own partner.
His own damn partner. Pogo the Clown. And that was a three count. Juan Tastico was eliminated. High cross body from Shady. One, Shady two. And only two.
And Pogo immediately turning as we get another two count. Pogo with his, well, former partner, I guess. He's not
look
happy.
At this. Yeah, exactly.
Sending Juan Tastico into the steel guardrail.
And now look at this. Pogo the Clown livid. Look at this face buster in the middle of the ring. From AWC and Shady on the cable. And Shabazz going for the pin. One, two, the tournament is still going. The titles are on the line.
As seen on TV, American Wildchild is looking to win this.
Look at this now. Going after Juan Tastico. I still can't believe it. I mean, Pogo had his sights set on winning this tournament. Blaming, obviously, the loss on Juan Tastico. As the action continues inside of the ring, there's action everywhere, Juan Head.
It's so hard to call. Juan Tastico was taken under the wing, under the shovel of Pogo the Clown.
Oh,
but he
no.
turned on him that quick, and look at the shovel with the barbed wire. Pogo the Clown does not care. Friends no more in the ring.
I'm not a lip reader, but I have a pretty good idea what he was saying and who he was saying it to. Irish Rip now from AWC. Mexico's most wanted.
Lip reading class.
Damian 666. Look at the speed of these two guys. Oh, beautiful springboard dropkick from the second rope onto AWC. One, two, and oh no, only two. And I still can't believe Juan Tastico down and out. Next to all the rubble, all the weapons, all the carnage here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. Pogo the Clown turning his back on him.
And we almost had American Wildchild pinning Damian 666 as the Lucha Libre chant erupts.
Snapmare takeover from AWC on to Damian 666 of Mexico's Most Wanted, going for the pin now once again. One, two, only two.
Nice combination kicks, almost putting away, tagging. Now
look at
tagging.
This. Oh my goodness.
Halloween, it's partner versus partner now.
Absolutely.
Claude.
Absolutely.
Now what the hell
both
happened?
These men are tagged in. Oh wait, look at this double team from behind. Yes. Mexico's Most Wanted going right after Shady and now. Oh no, look at this. Make a wish. Make a wish. Please, down!
Oh, God. The scrotum right into the steel ring post.
The what?
The scrotum, the testicle sac.
Oh, my God.
You know about that, don't you?
Please. Please. I saw you in the men's room with Angel earlier on. Now, it's Shady shucking and jiving. Oh, no. Look at that showboating and getting a foot right in the face. Just what he deserved for all that showboating. Off the ropes now, Halloween. Yes. Oh, no. Look at that, AWC from behind, out of nowhere, desperation, right after Halloween, and as he was going for Shady. Look at this, Shady up and over. Oh no, tumbleweed right on top of his own partner, AWC.
Well, their teamwork is not working tonight, and America, Mexican Most Wanted, Halloween, Damian 666. They've got this one, and they have their sights set on the gold.
And what a chop that was. As Mexico's most wanted, perching. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Yes. Yes, shoulder. Shoulder to shoulder from the neck, and I'm down. Go Shady. One.
Yeah, one, two.
And that's it. That's it.
That's it. It's down to these two final teams, Mexico's Most Wanted
and the Panthers.
Winner take all.
As AWC and Shady have been eliminated, now it's the Panthers against Mexico's Most Wanted. And you got to remember, Ron Head, that Mexico's Most Wanted have been the odds-on favorite to take the tag team title tournaments. Even before this tournament was even signed, these guys have been together for so many years and they've been in XPW for quite some time now. This should be interesting.
Well, the credentials of Mexico's Most Wanted does not impress the Black Panthers.
I don't need any insurance, credentials, State Farm, it doesn't matter now. Look at this, across the rope. Oh, look at that. Huge kick to the back, clothesline from Damian 666 as the other Panther goes down. Saheed Shehade. One, two, only two. Oh, look at that. Hey, Malik Shabazz just barely interrupting the count.
And Halloween, Damian 666, they have this one lined up and they don't care. Double teaming now.
Oh, look at that. Chest first right of the turnbuckle in a beautiful double team effort. From the men south of the border, yes. Double clothesline. And now it's Damian going for the pin. One, two, no. Once again, it's Hey, Malik Shabazz interrupting the count. Referee, you got to get this guy out of the ring. Mexico's Most Wanted would have had this match won on two different occasions by now, Ron Head.
Well, that time gets speared, hooks the leg. Are we going to see it? One, two, new champions, no. So close, it could go either way right now, Floss. Fireman's carry.
Fireman's carry up above now. Damian 666, yes. Planted in the center of the ring.
Nice Death Valley driver. And does not get a three count. It could go either way, so close. The Black Panthers want to take it back, and Patrick Hernandez doing an excellent job, Cloth.
Senior official west of the Mississippi, Patrick Hernandez. And now, K-Malik Shabazz. Oh, look at, small package, one, two, roll up, no.
Tucon again. Clothesline. Ducks underneath the clothesline. High forearm cross-body combination. Hooks the leg, one, two. No.
Only two once again. And another chop now from K-Malik Shabazz. And look at this, Irish whip, another beautiful reversal from Damian 666. Damian 666, oh look at this, going after Saheed Shehade. Oh, look at that Bronco Buster. And you can see the pained expression on the face of Shabazz.
Not happy with the stench either that must have left behind there. Oh. You know a little bit about that, don't you, Boss?
Well, I saw the Pico Rivera men's room out of toilet paper. However, another chop, two of them, three of them. And look at this now, arm ring, a reversal from K-Malik Shabazz, and a succession of chops from both men onto each other. Irish whip up, oh no, what a big, huge heel kick that was. And this could be it, one, two, no, that was only two again. I can't believe it, Ron Head.
He nailed him right on the jaw. I'm surprised he kicked out of that, but I'm being surprised a lot tonight. Now they're exchanging chops and a chant of Mexico, Mexico. And now, he's getting down, he's getting into business. Tearing the clothes off, and it's a chop fest, lighting each other's chests up.
Oh, look at that double clothesline, nobody moves. Look at these, both these men now, they want the XPW. Double high cross body, and both men go down.
Both of them have the same thing in mind. Both of them down, Patrick Hernandez administering the 10 count. Both these men have it until 10 to make it to their feet. And we're so close to seeing history, the first ever XPW World Tag Team Champions. So close. Now, Damian wanting to get tagged in. Halloween.
And there it is, yes. Yes, Damian 666. But of course, Saheed Shehade in the ring. But it's Damian 666 taking it to Shehade with two huge clotheslines. Up and over now. One, two, and oh, that was that close.
That time Malik Shabazz was there to break the count. Look!
What is this?
It's Lady Victoria.
What do you know about this one, man?
Lady Victoria sporting the new purple hairdo. And
look at this, grabbing the foot of the
referee. I thought she turned her back on Mexico's Most Wanted, but it looks like she's aligning herself.
Yes, double team effort, Lathrop.
a wheelbarrow into a leg drop. Victoria holding the ankle.
It's over!
Champion!
Mexico's most wanted are the undisputed tag team champions, and Lady Victoria is back in their corner.
XPW World Tag Team Champions, Mexico's most wanted.
Lady Victoria is back, but more importantly, the World Tag Team Champions of XPW, Mexico's most wanted, Damian 666 and Halloween. Coming to the ring, we saw him last year take a huge, horrific beating in the tournament. And once again, has this guy learned? Look at the way he's dressed. All he's got is traditional ring trunks, and he's going into a deathmatch tournament? This guy is nuts. What's he doing? Lozano going behind this car. This very shady-looking car. A possible game of peekaboo hide-and-go-seek. Telling everybody to shush. Rosano hiding behind the car. What is this? Oh my goodness, oh no, it's Crimson. Crimson, and here comes Rosano. Look at this, from the top, double axe handle behind. Crimson is Rosano. Still crashing down to the dirt. And now look at this Irish whip, now into the station wagon, off. Right into the station wagon. Ron Head joining us once again, unfortunately, at the ringside area. Now another Irish whip on the dirt. Look at this. Crimson with a reversal. Oh, small the back right into the Chevy.
I should point out that Steve Rosano, representing the Enterprise once again, is fighting in this tournament with no shirt, just in tight.
Just like he did last year, Ron Head.
And slid over the hood of the car into the dirt. The dirt where the bulls ride in Pico Rivera. Crimson is not giving him a chance to get his momentum started, and they're back on. Whose car is that anyway?
I believe it's International Talent Scouts Tony T's, perhaps.
Tony T better watch out. Trying to put together ChrisBloss.com here.
Look at this now. Look at this.
Is he going to pile drive? Is he going to powerbomb him on the roof of the car?
You've got to be kidding me. Wait a minute. Back body drop. Oh, no.
A backdrop onto the hood, almost putting a sunroof into Tony T's roof. Crimson now. That man is psychotic and deranged, bloodthirsty.
Oh, look at that elbow right to the back.
And
of Steve Rosano from the hood of the car onto all the dirt. All the duck poo-poo out here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena.
I'm not sure where that smell came from. Thought it may have been
You got the duck farms everywhere, buddy, out here. And look at this. Shot now right to the head from Crimson onto Steve Rosano, the Gigolo, member of the Enterprise.
Still, they have not made their way into the death match ring, the ring with the bed of thumbtacks.
Oh, no! Oh! Look at that! Yeah. Steve Rosano!
Fluorescent light tubes detonating the flesh, again exposed, and already the chest and maybe the jaw sliced open.
Look at this crutch to the back! Rosano! Why the hell did he come out in that attire?
Steve Rosano is bleeding from the mouth.
Oh!
Maybe internal bleeding. And that recyclable Alhambra water bottle.
And look out. Look out. The announce table. In the danger zone. Danger zone now. And look at the blood flowing from the face of Rosano. Where it's coming from, I don't know if it's extra internal. Very
Steve
good question.
Rosano.
Rosano, look. Sort of weapon he can get his hands on right now. Rosano with the cookie sheet in hand. Look at this now.
Metal cookie sheet.
Look at this. Oh no, boot to the midsection counter from Crimson. And now we're getting nasty. Now
that
we're getting
crutch.
Dirty. Oh, look at this. That crutch. Draped.
Dropped in barbed wire with glass. Barbed wire with glass on exposed flesh. And Steve Rosano is gushing blood.
My God, listen to that man, Crimson. Listen to him.
These fans could not be happier. These are the sickest bunch of fans.
Oh!
What was that, a Sony PlayStation?
I believe so.
Look at the marks left on the back of Steve Rosano.
Look at the marks on the back, indeed.
I'm talking about pain. You want to talk about pain, you get in there with barbed wire. They're going to rocket launch him.
Oh, look at this. Look at this. The Venom barbed wire. No. No. Oh, Rosano.
Breath slam onto a board of flesh shredding barbed wire. The agony that Steve Rosano must be in. And look.
Wait a minute. Pogo the Clown. Pogo the Clown. Look at this. Going right after Crimson. Both these men, these monsters. What the hell is Pogo doing out here, Runhead? What the hell is he doing out here?
Los Pogo must be very bitter in losing his chance of getting the tag team championship earlier. Is he putting himself in the deathmatch tournament?
I don't know. Obviously, the referee letting it go. I mean, pound for pound, these men match up so well with one another.
Look at the thousands of thumbtacks that can penetrate and sink into skin and meat and bone. Pogo the Clown is taking Crimson, launching him all the way out to the floor here, where barbed wire, where glass, where tacks, where all sorts of carnage is on the loose here. And Pogo the Clown, crisscross Pogo the Clown, I'm getting deja vu to last year's King of the Deathmatch Championship.
Wait a minute, we're not going to go to deja vu until after the show, Ronhead. Wait a minute, now look at this. Rosano, yeah, exactly, last year these two men were in the tournament against one another, and look at this powerbomb coming up. Oh no, you gotta be kidding me. Oh my god, did you see the impact? 1, 2, that's it, it's over.
And it's the Clown advancing.
Indeed, Pogo advancing in the tournament. Oh no, look at this, Crimson from behind with a steel chair. Pogo goes down.
Crimson not finished with him, not happy, the opportunity taken away from him. And oh, Cloth, I know you hate to relive memories like this, but
no,
he's
please.
Going for that
no,
razor
no.
sharp exacto blade.
This guy's sick, this guy's demented, both these men are, but I think Crimson even more so than Pogo the Clown.
And you know firsthand just what it feels like to be sliced open, a steel chair.
Please don't remind me.
Onto the back of Pogo the Clown, who has put himself in this tournament, and he will be advancing in the... Oh, now he's cutting Pogo's head with the X-Acto blade. Pogo the Clown is gushing blood. This is the first time ever remember Pogo the Clown being split
look
open ever.
Look at the face of Pogo. Pogo completely busted wide open.
And he's taking Pogo's blood once again, like everyone else, smearing the blood onto the mask. Pogo the Clown winning, advancing, but covered in, as Gordon Sully would say, a crimson mask. Crimson.
No pun intended, I hope. Pogo the Clown. Coming over to the announce table.
Guys,
this
everywhere.
This guy, I mean, he's taking a beating, but it's Pogo who advances in the tournament. And Crimson's got to be very upset, and he showed it just minutes ago.
Well, Pogo the Clown not slowing down one bit after his opportunity. Oh, look at Rosano, just his face, internally, maybe his mouth. Oh, this is nauseating.
This is nauseating, but Rosano giving his all. You got to give it up for the guy. But the bottom line is, the big story is, Pogo the Clown has advanced in the King of the Deathmatch Tournament. And what a match that was. Steel pipe. GQ Money, this very maniacal, very twisted individual, taking his time getting to the ring. As the tournament continues here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. What this guy's all about, where he's coming from, I don't know, fans. I really don't know. Oh my God! What does he have? No! No! God, no! He's got a barbed wire dildo! A barbed wire dildo! I thought I'd seen it all, folks. What a change of the hardcore homo. He's going to be going against GQ Money of the ED Enterprise.
Introducing first from Aspen, Colorado, representing the Enterprise, Ultraviolent GQ Money. His opponent from way west Hollywood, California, he is the hardcore homo. He is Angel.
And now the match underway. Angel going against GQ Money. And another match in the tournament. Look at right into that barbed wire, already getting hooked up. Oh no! Oh, it's Angel into the bed of nails. Clothesline dug to the knee. These two have had quite a history. And here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena, Ron Head joining us once again. But now the speed, the quickness, these two. Beautiful textbook suplex from GQ Money onto the hardcore homo Angel leg drop.
GQ Money and the hardcore homo. Who would have ever thought that Angel would be getting chance for his name, praising his name for the hardcore homo, ducking underneath the clothesline.
Back body drop over the top. And look at this, GQ Money springboard. Yes, oh, just barely losing his balance. And he came crashing down on the back of his head.
He hooked his foot on the barbed wire, and that sent him crashing face first.
Slipping off that rope. And now it's Angel, the hardcore homo. Oh, no, no. Look out, run ahead. We're in the danger zone. We're in the danger zone. And my name is not Kenny Loggins.
Cover.
Ah! You gotta be kidding me.
I brought my safety glasses, Chris Loggins. Those fluorescent light tubes detonating on the back of ultraviolent GQ Money.
And now there's glass shattered all over the ring. GQ Money, the first light bulb we've seen utilized in the tournament. Yes, over the top, and look at this, right onto that bed of barbed wire.
The bed of barbed wire that could shred the flesh, and Angel bringing a sex toy 2 foot long that was wrapped in barbed wire. You saw him swinging, you saw him waving it, and I still think GQ Money, one of the sickest minds, much like I wrote in the current issue of We Magazine, GQ Money is sick as they come. The fans now getting behind Angel. Who would have thunk it?
Look at this. Oh, right into the security railing goes GQ Money. Angel taking control just like he does with most men in his life. Oh, look at this. Right to the back. Right to the back again. It's Angel.
Damn him. Those cookie teeth are heavy as all hell. They're designed to withstand burning chocolate chip cookies and that.
Oh!
Fire! Ah! GQ Money getting ultraviolet. Throwing fire in the face.
Bulldog, bulldog right into that bed of barbed wire. And the hardcore homo suffering at the hands of another man. Usually he likes to suffer at the hands of another man, but not in this situation. And GQ Money going right after the hardcore homo.
And the chance of hardcore homo again.
Oh,
God.
Or as the tube light bulb right to the back of Angel from GQ Money.
And GQ's got that look in his eyes again.
And this has been one of the most extraordinary matches tonight. Aura, right to the back with that broomstick handle.
A broomstick to the back of the head.
And look at that.
usually Angel.
They're back down in the war zone. Look at that. It looks like a bat with light bulb fastened to it, and now picking the mini money.
The mini money. I never thought I'd see anything smaller than the real GQ money. Oh, look at this. Shot right between the eyes with that trash can of Angel from GQ money. And this, oh my goodness, look at this. You got to be kidding me. Run ahead.
There's maybe a half a dozen fluorescent light tubes taped together and a shovel. A shovel into the back and a hardcore homo.
And listen to the impact of that flat nose shovel. Oh, no. Oh. And look at this. Another fluorescent tube light bulb broken over the back of Angel.
And the glass is just shredding up the flesh.
There's glass everywhere.
Everywhere.
GQ money. Look at this. Blood streaming down his face. Angel trying to follow up, blood all over his body as well.
Can you imagine the kind of pain these men are going through? The kind of pain that they're going to have to suffer tonight, Klopp.
Angel now, look at this. Oh no, chair right to the back.
Chairs and a whole bundle of fluorescent light tubes.
Look at this. You have got to be kidding me, Angel. Just barely getting into the ring, but it's GQ Money setting two chairs up with that, like you said, half a dozen fluorescent tube light bulbs right on top of both of them for the leverage. You got to be kidding me, Ron Head. You have got to be kidding me.
This is no joke. A makeshift sawhorse digging a superplexum through the fluorescent light tubes and open chairs. Something bad's going to happen.
Look at this.
DDT, a super DDT from the top. Oh,
one, two, no! I thought that was it for sure, Ron Head.
So close. How the hell is he going to kick out of that? How the hell can anyone kick out and still keep going?
Wait a minute. Look. It's Veronica Kane.
Veronica Kane has made her way ringside.
Oh.
Give me another one, Klaus. Give me another.
See her.
The match is still in progress, Chris Klaus. Yeah. This death match into the scaffold. That is a tub passing by mousetrap.
They got to watch that scaffold. That thing can teeter any way possible. But look at this now. Angel, GQ Money in the death match tournament going at it with one another. So far, this has been the sleeper match of the night. But both these men have had a history with one another, especially here on head at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. And no, before being utilized once again. Tony T's got to be kicking himself right now.
Tony T's got to be regretting it, but a vertical suplex.
Oh, and the windshield.
You have a ride home later on, Klaus. Talk to me about it.
Usually I carpool with Tony T, but he's got that survival insurance. And we know how good that stuff is. Look at this. Look at the forehead cut from Angel.
Over the eye. Angel, obviously tonight, with two purple heads.
And now look at this. I'm not going there. And now look at this. GQ Money going into ring number one to get another weapon. And look at this. Oh, he's got his steel, his trademark steel bar. And Angel still laid out on the hood of Tony T's car.
The violence!
Oh, it's right into the windshield. And Angel is very lucky he got out of the way.
Aren't you happy he didn't go and use that windshield cleaner earlier?
Oh!
Again.
It was only the store brand.
And Veronica Kane getting involved. Veronica Kane now with the steel pipe onto the back of the hardcore homosexual.
And look at this.
Veronica Kane not shy about getting involved on behalf of the Enterprise. She wants to take it all the way to the finals. She wants her man, Ultra Violent, to go all the way to the championship. Now kicking away, Veronica Kane, plus Veronica Kane, fearless, sick, and say it.
Oh, well, look at this now. GQ Money going after Angel, the hardcore homo, once again. Look at this. Scoop up. And a slam, perhaps. Oh, no. You got to be kidding me. Oh, look at that. Oh, just his jaw. His jaw was dropped right on the hood of that, or the roof of that car. And now look at this. Look at this. It's Angel on the roof of the car once again. GQ Money following him up.
And Angel now slowly trying to recover. And what the hell? He's got fluid. He's got charcoal fluid.
Oh, no. Oh, look at this spider fluid.
Are we going to see a fire? Are we going to see a human body go through He's not going to light that table on fire. We've seen what's happened when fire's been introduced to a match. Tell me it's not going to happen, Klopp. Tell me this table, this person will not be lit on fire.
Settle down, Ron Hebsingus, right now. Look at this. A plethora, a very precipitous amount of lighter fluid being doused on that table. And GQ Money still laid out on the roof of this car. And look at this now. Veronica Kane, it looks like she has a book of matches. Go, go, go. No, look at this.
Trying to start the fire. The wind's blowing into Pico Rivera. Oh, no. Fire has been lit.
Look at this.
The table is on fire. Anything can happen.
Look at this. The table engulfed in flames. The table, but Angel. And GQ Money's still on the hood of that car. And look at this now.
The hardcore homo struggling. Ultra-violent GQ is struggling. And the table. Veronica Kane doing what she can to set the table on
fire.
Wait
a minute, GQ Money with that lighter fluid. You got to be kidding me. Spraying more.
This is what happened last time. We've seen it months and months ago. Supreme went up
in flames. Oh, my God, don't remind me. Do not remind me. Look at this powerbomb, perhaps. No, a big body drop. And GQ Money. GQ Money.
Maybe.
My God. Angel now with a high cross body. One,
two,
and
three.
That's it. It's over. It is over. Angel advancing in the tournament.
Here is your winner. Here is your winner. And advance.
Angel advancing, GQ Money. That match could have gone either way. But it's Angel advancing. And what a tournament this has been. What a tournament it's shaping up to be. My goodness. My goodness.
GQ Money, he's got that look. He wanted to burn the hardcore homo to a hardcore crisp. A bloody, bloody tournament.
Building match.
Falls count anywhere as Snuff heads to the ring. Very reminiscent of the former man we knew as Tool here at XPW. Hey. And of course, we saw this man last time here at the Pico Rivera Sports Ring. Yes, yes, there he is. There he is. Vicious. Vic Grimes. And he's got a quintuple pizza cutter. Yes, mine. Very reminiscent. Well, if you can remember Freddy Krueger, he's numero uno. And the match is underway. It's Snuff and Vicious Vic Grimes out. Clothesline and a huge clothesline as Snuff goes down. This is a Falls Count Anywhere match at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. Spinning leg drop from Vicious Vic Grimes on to none other than Snuff.
This is a Pin Falls Count Anywhere matchup, Chris Kloss, when one man can slam or powerbomb or do whatever through that ladder of fluorescent light tubes perched up against the far wall of Pico Rivera. Then a pinfall can take place. But Vicious Vic Grimes has...
What?
You heard me. They got to go through that fluorescent light tube ladder there. Vicious Vic Grimes played hooky at old school. And that time, Snuff, Snuff, dropping Vicious Vic Grimes crotch first as Snuff's manager, the sleazy J.R. Benson, looks on with great delight. And there he is right there, J.R. Benson, that sleazy pornography dealer who likes to grab men in the balls.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Making this a two-on-one.
that the sleazy pornographer, of course, J.R. Benson, hailing from the San Fernando Valley. Look at this, elbow drop to the back of the neck of Vicious Vic Grimes, and Vicious Vic Grimes was crashing down. And this snuff guy's scary. He's got to scare you. He scares me.
I don't want to get anywhere near this guy. Maybe getting a little bit of sexual enjoyment watching other people. Ah, J.R. Benson now slapping Vic Grimes across the face.
I would hate to be walking down a dark alley one night and meeting snuff. I don't even know if this guy the size of him can fit down a dark alley one night. Look at this. Irish whip. Oh, big clothesline from out of nowhere. And what is J.R. Benson doing in the ring? Look at this now. Vicious Vic Grimes is going to have his fun with this guy. Look at this. Up high above his head. Oh, beautiful.
Press slam into a diamond cutter, sending J.R. Benson, that sleazy, scummy manager,
but
down.
I can't understand what J.R. Benson's trying to accomplish in the ring with Vicious Vic Grimes. And now it's Grimes going after both men's stuff and J.R. Benson.
Nobody gave Benson credit for having
the quintuple pizza cutter. Look at this.
The multi-bladed pizza cutter.
Oh! Right to the head.
Trying to make Vic Delicious bite-sized bits out of J.R. Benson's
head. This is sick.
Cutting J.R. Benson's face into little bite-sized bits as the blood is starting to flow here.
My goodness, look at this. This is sick.
Freddy Krueger has nothing on J.R. Benson. Wolverine is a sheer wussy compared to that man with his pizza cutter.
Quintuple indeed, pizza cutter 5. And now look at this. It's snuff going right after Vicious Vic Grimes, who just had his way with J.R. Benson. But I think perhaps he wasted his time with Benson, because snuff getting the upper hand right now in this Falls Count Anywhere match in the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. And what a night it's been, what a night it's going to turn out to be. We still got the scaffold run head. We still got the rest of the deathmatch tournament into the guardrail. Yes, Vicious Vic Grimes was crashing back first.
And we still have the XPW World Heavyweight Championship to be decided later on.
That's right, because Webb will be defending against a mystery opponent, member from the Enterprise that Veronica Kane selects. And if you ask me, it's got to be chaos.
Have you ever seen somebody able to manhandle Vicious Vic Grimes like this man Snuff? He's got to be pushing that 7-foot mark. The man has got sickness written all over him.
This guy's a monster. He's a monster. Oh, look at this. Right into the, no. No, back body drop under the trunk of the car.
And that car has bits of broken glass all over it. Whose car is that, Kloss?
I believe it's from the Norwalk Auto Auction. Now look at this. Going up top of the roof of the car. Vicious Vic Grimes drops the big elbow from the trunk down on top of Snuff on the ground floor here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. And remember, Ron Head, Falls Count Anywhere.
Especially after one man must put the other through a ladder of fluorescent light tubes. And look at Benson.
J.R. Yeah. Benson. Oh, look at the thumbtacks. Thumbtacks methodically being spread on the trunk of the car.
Thousands and thousands of death tacks onto the trunk, and it's got J.R. Benson written all over him.
Oh, no, look at this. Powerbomb perhaps coming up, yes. Look at this. Razor's Edge. No. Oh!
Ah! Those thumbtacks put a smile on Vic Grimes' face as a bloody pervert J.R. Benson looks like a human pincushion dealing smut.
Are you okay?
I don't feel so good right now.
You don't look so good either. Look at this now, Irish whip. Look at this, Vic Grimes. Oh my goodness. Just barely landing on his back, almost the back of his neck. The dent in the car, that's it. We know Tony T was insured by Survival. I don't know what the insurance coverage is on this car, but nonetheless, Snuff taking it to Vicious Vic Grimes.
That car is dented. Imagine the kind of damage inflicted upon the legs of Vic Grimes.
And now J.R. Benson still laid out by the ringside area. Snuff throwing Grimes back into the ring, and this match continues, and it's back into the ring. Does it matter? No, because it's a Falls Count Anywhere match. And look at this. 1-2, referee totally out of position. 1-2, and that was for sure a 3-count right there, Runhead.
Well,
this referee has got to get his act together.
He's got to have eyes on the back of his head there, keeping J.R. Benson, who's bloody as all hell on the floor, trying to keep him out of this false count match.
What the hell is he worrying about Benson for? Benson's laid out, and now it's Snuff laying out Vicious Vic Grimes now.
Well, you just got to think what kind of diseases that sleazy porn dealer has, and the kind of diseases you can pick up from swapping bodily fluids with J.R. Benson. I said it.
Are you sure you're okay?
I don't think I'm ever gonna be okay after this.
You don't look okay. Now look at this now, knee to the midsection from Snuff. Onto the big man, Vicious Vic Grimes, Irish whip. No, a reversal from the big man, chest first. Look at this, off the rope, clothesline, forearm shot. As Snuff goes down in this match, both these monsters going at it, toe to toe, face to face. But now it's Grimes going upstairs, and look at this run head, the elevation from the big man. Grimes drops the big elbow on the Snuff.
A froggy style elbow, 1-2. Big Grimes with the first ever frog style elbow, over 400 pounds sailing in the air. And Big Grimes is feeling that second wind, getting that fire back, ignoring the pain, ignoring potential diseases that might be inflicted on him. To the top.
Look at this now, splash.
Nuclear splash from the top.
Splash from Grimes, no, only two run head. And both these men giving it their all in this matchup here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena, the Night of Champions. Grimes once again going upstairs, and this is going to be the third time, the third attempt.
Is it going to be three times the charm? All the way.
Leg drop.
A guillotine leg drop all the way.
1-2, and no! Oh, was that close? That was close, Ron Head.
Well, this Snuff has proven to be a one tough son of a gun. Snuff has proven that it's gonna take a lot to put him away. And Vic Grimes,
he's signaling
to go to the top again for a fourth time.
Vic Grimes. Look at this, J.R. Benson now. Oh no, shot to the groin, but no effect, barely. What is this guy thinking? This guy's a nut, he's stupid, he's a lunatic.
He's got him by maybe four times the body weight.
Oh no, look at
he's
this.
He's trying to hurricane run a Vic Grimes. He's gonna drop him. Oh, I've seen this.
Oh!
The Wild Fandango!
But he missed. Can you imagine if he nailed that right on top of Snuff? That would have been it for sure. But that's got to be it for sure for J.R. Benson. Snuff had a lot of time to regroup as he's getting to his feet now with that steel chair in hand. Oh, no, look at this. Oh, what a shot that was right to the head of Vicious Vic Grimes.
Denting that steel chair onto the head of Vic Grimes with a temporary distraction. 1, 2, 3. Felony. Almost counting three.
And Snuff, look at Snuff. Snuff's living.
And J.R. Benson flattened. The blood loss is immense. Puddles of blood are everywhere. And Snuff now removing the chair, manhandling Vic Grimes and sending him to the floor. And it looks like, yes, they are headed for the ladder of fluorescent light detonators.
Oh my goodness, look at this now. Snuff with Vicious Vic Grimes in hands, and yes, I believe you're right. I believe you're right, Ron Head, for the first time in your life. Oh no, look at this, stopping in his tracks now. Oh, did you see that? Snuff throwing that chair at Vicious Vic Grimes and doing it right through that huge, and I mean huge, bed of light bulbs. But once again, Vic Grimes with Snuff in hand. Look at this, the light bulbs.
Something bad's about to happen.
You gotta be kidding me, Head, no.
It's gonna happen. It's gotta happen. One of these two men will go through one of these fluorescent light tube ladders. Oh God, it's gonna. No, Snuff blocking it.
Big run through the light bulbs. 1, 2. Is that it? That was three. Advancing in the match, taking it to Vicious Vic Grimes. Snuff victorious.
With the help of that sleazy, bloody, disease-ridden J.R. Benson. J.R. Benson, the bloody heap, being carried out like the bitch that he is. Snuff has gotten one over on Vicious Vic Grimes, laying in a heap of glass and dirt and his own blood.
Lance Luke of the Ultra Boys. A very surprising advance in the first round. Supreme! What a contrast to this matchup, folks! Irish whip now, Supreme, ducking underneath the clothesline from Luke the Matthew Boy. Look, the Altar Boy. And look at this now, kick succession of him. Look at this.
Taking the bandage off of the head of Supreme, who was busted open earlier on in this tournament.
What the hell was that? He crossed him and then he kicked him. Talk about a religious guy, give me a break. Look at this now.
Springboard spin kick sending Supreme down right between the eyes. Another upset.
You gotta be kidding me. One, two, only two. You gotta be. Give me a break.
Well, who would have thought that he could have pinned Vinny Massaro, the son of Sicily, earlier on in the night?
But you're talking about Supreme now. Supreme, oh, look at that chair shot to the back. Supreme suffering earlier at the hands of, well, you saw it. It was the Sandman. But now, only a one count.
Well, Supreme, a bloody mess already. Earlier on, the Sandman busted him open. Altar Boy Luke taking advantage, much like the Men of the Cloth may have taken advantage of him.
Oh, look at this now. 450 splash from the top one. Only two.
We can very well see an upset here tonight. This Altar Boy Luke may feel like he has the power of the Lord on his side.
Aren't you Jewish?
Shalom, Chris Cloth.
Look at
Shalom.
This now.
I just want peace here tonight with you.
Look at this now. Oh.
Somersault leg drop to the back of the head, sending both men into that tub of thumbtacks.
I saw Luke trying to cross you, and you wanted him to give you the old star. Look at this now, only two.
Two count only, and Supreme, do you think he may have underestimated the Altar Boy?
I don't know. These Altar Boys scare me. Once again, it's like I'm in a Benny Hinn revival when I see these guys. And oh, you gotta be kidding me! Glass! Flying everywhere!
Right.
A shard of glass right next to me. Oh!
Right between it. Ow!
And look at this, the light bulb's being destroyed.
That glass is...
Light bulbs everywhere. All over the announce table, all over us.
They're getting all over the audience.
You gotta be kidding me, this is nuts. This is sex Supreme. And now it's Supreme taking over, taking control, just like he does, as he is the true king of the deathmatch, the original, here in XPW Runhead.
This has just become, well, we've heard a smorgasbord of violence. This is uncooked, this is bloody, and the Altar Boy is now bleeding, much like Supreme is bleeding. Again, glass getting everywhere.
It got on me, for God's sakes, here.
Lonehead, settle down.
I can't help it. I'm bleeding all over you here, Claw.
Bleeding all over? Look at Luke. Luke is bleeding profusely. Luke, taking it. Supreme, earlier in this match.
The glass is spraying all over the ringsiders here. Fan participation has been not only permitted, but encouraged.
Oh!
God!
One head busted wide open here at the ringside table.
Nobody, and I mean nobody, is safe. Even when you assume the position in the broadcast position. And that is a tub of
mousetraps.
They're loaded up with cheese, and those mousetraps can strike at the first person.
Oh, using the leverage. Look at these mousetraps.
Larry the cheese. Supreme lands right in the tub of mousetraps.
And look at this now. Supreme not laying in the right position for those mousetraps to be going off. Luke of the Altar Boys going after Supreme once again. Earlier was Supreme, and look at this. Oh, right back into the ring.
This has become a bloody freaking night. Bloodier than I had ever intended. Bloodier than I had ever anticipated.
Look at
this.
Sorry, I
may have gotten blood on your sports coat there, Cloth.
Well, look at this. The cleaner's bill will be in your mail.
Did you at least save the receipt for the jacket? Look at the blood just gushing. Imagine the pain in the head of the Altar Boy. And Supreme also trying to shake it off. The winner of this man will advance all the way to the finals.
Look at this now. Supreme with Luke right where he wants him.
The blood loss has been immense, and now the Altar Boy perched on top.
Oh, no! No!
Bits of glass are flying everywhere.
This is not Dolph Supreme into that bed of barbed wire, and now it's Luke. Look at this, Luke, from the top. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Luke from the top.
What an incredible matchup here. What a showing we're seeing. Not only by Supreme, but a surprise showing by the Altar Boy, Luke.
XPW, the best damn wrestling entertainment there is worldwide. And look at this huge flash. 1, 2, it's over. It's over.
Nothing to be ashamed of. Altar Boy, Luke, did not do it. But this man has made a name for himself. Here is your winner. And advancing in the XPW King of the Deathmatch Tournament, Supreme.
That's right, Supreme advances. And this match could have gone either way. But you're right, Luke has nothing to be ashamed of. And these Altar Boys are going to go far in XPW. Supreme advances in the third annual XPW King of the Deathmatch Tournament. This should be Angel and Pogo the Clown. Angel, the hardcore homo. Go against Pogo the Clown. And I see a miracle. I see a miracle happening if Angel were to win this match.
The following match is scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute time limit, and it is a semi-final matchup in the XPW King of the Death Match Tournament. Introducing first from Chicago, Illinois,
Pogo the Clown.
Look at this, the toilet seat on Ron Head's head. Ron Head coming back to the announce table. Goofball. What a dummy this guy is. And look at this angel. He's very careful now. He knows he has his work cut out for him in this match.
Maybe you may want to try and go and introduce these two crazy jerks.
They do a hell of a lot better job than you've been doing. And now look at this, Pogo the Clown.
I hope you saved the receipt for that sports coat there, because it's stained for good.
But look at this stuff. Oh my God!
The hardcore homo platin, the fat one.
Oh! And Pogo just planted a clothesline and planting Angel right into the mat. What a clothesline that was, Ron Head.
Clothesline him straight out of the closet, the hardcore homo.
Oh, right to the back.
A surprise entry in this tournament earlier on. Pogo the Clown smacking that garbage trash can lid onto Angel. And now he's got the shovel. He wants to bury Angel in the basement, putting the trash can again on the head of Angel.
Oh my goodness, the impact. The flat nose shovel right to the trash can. That was on the head of Angel.
Anyone says this crazy clown ain't hardcore, you ain't been in there with him. This man is hardcore and sick to the damn bone cloth.
Well, look at this. He's taking it to Angel, and Angel, he needs a prayer right now. Look at this backbreaker. Nicely executed. From Pogo the Clown on to Angel. And in my book, Pogo the Clown is the odds-on favorite, possibly to take this tournament. But don't forget about Supreme.
And let's not count the hardcore homo out. Say what you want about the odds-on favorite.
Oh my gosh, look at that elbow.
420 pounds of back elbow into the hardcore homo jaw. Angel's halo has been shattered right before our bloody eyes.
What's wrong with you? What is wrong with you?
I don't feel so good. You don't smell so good, Claude.
You don't look good at all, Ron Head. And look at this choke now from Pogo the Clown on to Angel. Angel really once again suffering at the hands of Pogo and begging at the mercy of the feet of Pogo. And Pogo's just toying with Angel.
The barbed wire is sticking through the flesh. And let me tell you, my arm may be scraped up because that barbed wire has shredded me when Pogo backed me in.
Look at this now, shovel right to the head of Angel.
That could be a knockout blow. A knockout blow. Angel going down, but how long will Angel stay down?
Look at the face of Pogo. I mean, what a sick, twisted individual. And I still can't believe what he did earlier today to my broadcast colleague, Juan Tastico. Juan Tastico still suffering at the hands of Pogo. And look at this, oh! Sidewalk slam!
Right into
the bed of barbed wire, exactly right, Chris Kwan. And now look at this. It's Pogo getting to his feet. And Angel, look at the pain expression on his face. Usually he likes pain in a different way, Ron Head.
Well, if you don't lube it up just right, it's gonna hurt.
Only you would know. And now look at this, Angel.
Backed up into the bed of nails. Those nails are rusty.
Oh, look at this. Oh, my goodness. Into that bed of barbed wire. Perched in the corner.
Think of the pain this man must be suffering through right now.
Look at Pogo eyeing Angel. And now, no. Oh, no. Angel just barely getting out of the way.
That crazy clown going shoulder first now. And Angel, that's a candlestick with bits of glass, sharp glass.
Oh! Look at that glass.
That glass is crazy glued to that candlestick.
Roll package. One, two. Oh, no.
An upset, Chris Claus.
That has got to be the biggest upset of the year here at XPW. That man right there, Angel advancing.
Who would have thought that could happen? Here is your winner and advancing in the tournament, Angel.
World Television Champion.
The TV title is on the line. As Confederate currency, Chris Hammer makes his way to the ring. The man who very easily could have walked out of the Pico Rivera Sports Arena last month with the gold around his waist until that near fatal blow as the landmine just nearly killed, and I do mean killed, fans, Lizzie Borden. It was close, but Chaos was able to distract Chris Hamrick as Hamrick was distracted from Chaos. Excuse me, distracted with a bomb going out of Lizzie Borden. Chaos getting the victory. And wait a minute, what is this? Psychosis now, coming to the ring. Psychosis could walk out of here as the television champion. Look at this, the TV title hanging high above the rafters. And here comes the champion, Chaos. There he is, the XPW TV champ, Chaos. And he looks naked without that belt around his waist. Of course, the belt hanging high above the scaffold. The 40-foot high scaffold here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. And whoever captures that belt will be declared the undisputed XPW television champion. A packed house here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. It's Chaos showing his stuff, the TV champ.
Introducing first challenger number one from Bristol, Tennessee, Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick.
Chris Hamrick now. Getting quite the ovation
challenger
here.
Number two from Tijuana, Mexico, Psychosis. And from Hollywood, California, representing the Enterprise, he is the current reigning and defending XPW World Television Champion. Here is The Rock Superstar, Chaos.
This is going to be a three-way war. The first man to capture the XPW TV title hanging high above the scaffold will be declared the undisputed XPW World Television Champion. What a battle this should be, and what a match that was last month between one-on-one Chaos and Confederate currency Chris Hamrick. These two have quite a history together. They're barking at one another in psychosis and just laughing at it.
All three of these men with a surprising amount of experience, maybe over 30 years of wrestling experience. The man with the least amount, but the man, the odds-on favorite, the champ. The Rock Superstar Chaos, and he's got two of the finest contenders in the industry today. Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick, and Psychosis.
Armbar now, arm ringer from Chaos, and now a reversal from Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick, somersault counter now. From Chaos, another arm ringer of his own. And now look at it. Oh, look at Psychosis just sneaking into the ring. Now these two are going at it. Look at this springboard. And look at this. Japanese arm drag. Another arm drag. From Chaos on a Confederate currency. A counter now from currency. And now it's Chaos with one of his own. And these two match up very beautifully together.
The fans very appreciative, as is Psychosis, who's sitting back and letting these two athletes go at it.
Because these two athletes definitely have a history. Snap mare and an elbow drop miss. But it's Psychosis missing again. All three men missing. Look at this Confederate currency. Another arm drag. Another arm drag now from Chaos on to Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick. And now look at this. It's Psychosis with an arm drag. And all three of these men showing what they're made of. And they're all gunning for the XPW TV title.
Chris Hamrick has come so close on several different occasions to getting that XPW World Television Championship. Kid Chaos still the only man undefeated as the XPW World Television Champion. Chris Hamrick so close, Chris Kloss, as is Psychosis. Will tonight be the night? Will the night of champions be a night that will be remembered as the night Chaos suffered his loss?
You're a lonely man, aren't you?
Very lonely.
And look at this now. Oh, Psychosis shoved. He was trying to set the ladder while these two guys were fighting to get the title. But look at this, Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick going right after Chaos. And this could be both these men's weakness. Huge clothesline from Psychosis as Chaos goes down. I mean, Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick and Kiss. Look at that baseball sliding dropkick from currency onto Chaos. The TV title is on the line. The TV title is hanging above, high above by the scaffold. Oh my gosh, look at this. Psychosis, high cross body on top of both Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick, and the TV champ Chaos.
Over the top turnbuckle, the ladder, and the ring post. All the way onto the floor, all three of these men down. It could go any way right now. Chris Chaos is in a little bit more trouble than he may have anticipated here. Without the presence of Veronica King, without the presence of GQ Money, the Rock Superstar Chaos has to do it alone here tonight.
Irish whip reversal from Chris Hamrick. Look at this, body scissors now. Oh no, current counter from currency into a face buster right on top of Psychosis.
And this match, pinfalls will not count. You have to retrieve the ladder. You can use it as a weapon, but you need to retrieve the ladder.
And look at this reverse Boston Crab counter into a surfboard type maneuver. Yes, look at this.
Send him into the Kyoko Inoue swing set, Psychosis. A submission doesn't count, and a reverse atomic knee drop now. Grape finds the leg.
Look at this now. Look at this. Double submission, and look at this tapping out, but tap outs do not count. Exactly right, Roundhead. Look at this beautiful heel kick from Hamrick onto Chaos.
You can tap till the cows come home, you could say uncle all night, but the main objective is to grab that ladder and get that all-important World Television Championship belt.
Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick now with both men down right where he wants them. Look at this, currency measuring. I don't know who he's taking a little risk but himself right now. Sitting on the top rope, trying to gain some composure himself. Double axe handle as Chaos goes down. Currency measured him beautifully. And now, once again, Chris Hamrick from the top. Drops the elbow. No. Chaos just barely, and I mean barely, Roundhead moved out of the way. Now it's Chaos trying to capitalize.
Even without the Enterprise in his corner, Chaos is still wise enough, able to muster up the energy and the smartness. That time, a full body slam on Chaos by Chaos on Psychosis.
Look at this springboard moonsault landing right on top.
Down.
Right on top of Psychosis. Psychosis suffering now in currency. Laying flat on his back, perhaps getting a respite himself. And now look at this into the far side. Oh, what a kick that was. Right to the jaw, right to the face of Chaos. And now look at this possible tornado DDT coming up from the second rope. Yes, it's, oh no, but it's Chaos reversing it. Look at this, Hamrick. Hamrick now, both men, Hamrick. Oh.
Incredible double team maneuver that
into
time.
A stunner.
Chris Hamrick nailing the stunner out of a tornado DDT attempt. Chris Hamrick needs to capitalize on the situation. He needs to get that ladder. He needs to climb it and get the belt. He needs to do it now.
Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick. He's got the advantage now. And look at this now. Both Psychosis and Chaos going at it. And this could, you could be right.
The pace that these athletes are going, 1,500 miles an hour.
Look at this now, Chaos. Oh my gosh, make a wish. Oh!
Chaos again, the scrotum. The testicles right into the steel post. Doesn't feel good, Kloss. Take it from me.
Look at this now. Once again, Ron Head, a very lonely man. Irish whip boot to the midsection from Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick on the Psychosis. Oh no! It was a powerbomb attempt from Confederate currency. Chris Hamrick reversed into a facebuster from Psychosis. And now Psychosis, yes, Psychosis is going for the ladder. Psychosis will be going. Looks like very shortly, the XPW TV title. Now where is he going?
Going
He's grabbing a chair.
Row.
Look at this, from one of the ringsiders. Psychosis.
The Rock Superstar, the champion, is in trouble.
Oh no, oh no.
You have got to be kidding me. Look at where he just perched that ladder. No, and he's got that chair. Ah! It's Confederate currency with that ladder right between his legs.
And Chaos going face first into the legs of the ladder. Psychosis better capitalize on this advantage. He needs to capitalize.
What an opportunity he has right now, Ronhead, to grab, to capture, to hold the undisputed XPW Television Championship belt. But no, look at this. He's going right after Chaos once again. I don't know if this is a very smart game plan right here on the part of Psychosis, Ronhead. However,
decapitate, trying to dismember, he's and trying, using that ladder.
He's trying to send a message to both men. He's trying to send a message to everybody here at XPW that he means business. Oh, no!
How much abuse can the Rock superstar take?
And look at the face! Look at the blood just spewing out of the head, out of the eyes, out of everywhere from Chaos. Oh, look at that. What a reversal that was. Desperation.
A slide kick into the ladder again. Into the sack of Chaos.
Look at that now. Beautiful.
Enziguri. Enziguri into the head. Yakuza kick now into the head of Psychosis. Chris Hammer, Confederate currency. Trying to do it again to slow the man down as Chaos is down. The fans counting. 10 times into the face of El Nicho. Psychosis is in trouble. Chaos still staggered. Chris Hamrick, he needs to do something. Do it soon if he wants to be champion.
Look
that ladder
though.
Now perpendicular, parallel with the body of Psychosis.
Look at this now. And once again, the ladder in between Psychosis and Chaos. But it's Chris Hamrick with the advantage right now, looking for something.
Making a ladder sandwich right now. Another, a double decker, another 20 plus foot ladder is being introduced. The blood is flowing like Niagara Falls.
And Ron Head, this is ridiculous. This is nuts. It looks like this has turned into a death match. This was only the match for the XPW television title. And look at this, Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick. You've got to be kidding me. Look at the distance. Look at this.
All beef patty sandwich between two ladders.
Freeboard. And he nails both men. Both ladders go crashing, but all three men are down.
20 plus feet across the ring.
And look at the blood. Look at that.
Blood everywhere. It's flowing out of the head. The champion is in so much trouble. It can be anyone's game right now.
This match can go either way. Any of three different ways. Chaos, Psychosis, Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick all gunning for the XPW World Television title. But the champion is to his feet first. And he's got the extra tall ladder. And look at this. Is he setting it up? Is he going to go for the title belt right now? He's looking up.
What a match. What a war we're seeing these men put themselves through. The abuse they submit their bodies to climb the ladder and get that all-important XPW World Television Championship. And it looks like
Chaos. And there it is. There it is right there.
That precious Chaos, title yes. That's almost always around the waist of the Rock superstar Chaos, hanging precariously.
Usually his security blanket, if you will.
A security blanket is one thing, but that thing is tattooed around the waist. He was kicking and screaming to have that title belt perched above the ring, and he's about to get it back now. He's going to retain that championship in a matter of
seconds. Ron Head, I think you're wrong. For the 1,000th time in your life, I think you're wrong. Look at this. Chaos.
Maybe
what is he thinking?
Point,
oh,
what's
no.
he doing?
Moonsault from the ladder. No. Oh, and he missed. Did you see the elevation? Did you see the elevation?
Incredible damn hang time we're seeing there. Nobody home. The Rock superstar Chaos may have injured himself, and now El Nicho Psychosis now dropping the ladder, and we might see a new champion. We might see a man who can take that title back to Mexico. Psychosis inches away.
And I don't even understand how Chaos is walking, but yes, run ahead. Look at this. Inches, centimeters, millimeters away from the belt. Yeah, look at this. There it is. But no, Confederate currency on his feet. Oh, no. Look at this. The ladder teetering. Oh! Clothesline right on top of that top rope.
and that may have knocked Psychosis out. That may have knocked the man out. He's not moving, as that top rope steel cable may have taken the face and sliced it off of Psychosis.
Taking the life out of Psychosis.
That is a lifeless body right there. Now a chair.
Oh, look at that, right to the small of the back. Chaos swung that chair with all his might that he has right now. Very winded in this match. A lot has been taken out of all three men. However, there's still, the heart is in this. All three men are still gunning for the XPW TV title. And you can see a lot has been taken out of Chaos. Literally, look at the blood flowing down his face, Ron Head.
The blood, the energy, but one thing that is not taken away is the determination, the sheer guts. And I hate to give the man credit, but that man has more guts.
Oh, what a chop! What a chop that was from Psychosis!
Don't count the challengers out, however.
Oh, shoulder first to the near side of ring number two.
Into the post, the shoulder right into the post. Psychosis has had shoulder problems over the years. That's not going to help his matter any. Now two ladders, both ladders in stereo now being perched up. It can be any game.
Chaos climbing the wrong side of the ladder, but it looks like he doesn't give a damn.
I tell you, whoever wins this match, the other two men will have nothing to be ashamed of, as this may be the most physical, maybe one of the greatest.
And look at this. It's a race for the title. Chaos and Hamrick both going up.
Looks like Chaos has it.
No, he just batted it away now. He's going after, look at Psychosis going after Confederate Currency on the other ladder.
Chaos now kicked off. Both Chaos kicking off Psychosis. Chaos.
Look at this, the title. The title. Both men have it.
They both have their hands on the belt. They both have their grasp on the title.
And they're both hanging from the chain. Psychosis. No, you got to be kidding me. He's taking the ladder out from both of them.
Psychosis has taken one ladder. Both men hanging on for dear life.
And
hanging
now the other ladder.
They're hanging up on the ring.
They're hanging from the rafter on the chain. Psychosis going up. Psychosis going up. How long can these men hang?
The ladder now almost taken away from them. Who's going to get the title belt? And now, again, they're hanging up. The fans going berserk.
And look at referee Patrick Hernandez. Oh, my goodness. Psychosis hanging from the legs. And can this chain hold?
Down goes Psychosis.
Down goes Psychosis, and down goes the ladder, perhaps. This ladder teetering in the middle of the ring. Oh, my.
What the hell?
What the hell just happened? What's the verdict? What is the verdict? And where's the title?
All three men are down. The championship belt down.
Wait a minute. The first time in the history of a ladder match. And look how confused referee Hernandez is. But what's the official word? Ron Head going to the ring right now. Hopefully we can shed some light on the subject. What? Apparently, Chaos retains the title.
And still,
well, Psychosis obviously not the winner. It's either Chaos or Confederate Currency, Chris Hamrick. But Chaos leaving with the title.
Patrick Hernandez declaring this match a no contest. Still, XPW World Television Champion, The Rock Superstar, Chaos.
Well, there you have it, fans. A no contest, a no decision, as Chaos will still walk out of here with the XPW television title. I mean, Currency and both Chaos, both with their hands on the title, falling to the ground at the exact same time. That has never happened before in the history of a ladder match. However, Chaos walks out of here with the gold, a no contest.
I guess we're doing intermission now. Is that it? Are there any other ones besides the two others? No, I don't have a reason.
World Heavyweight Championship. Your referee, Patrick Hernandez.
Heavyweight champion. But the big question is, who has Veronica Kane selected from the Enterprise to go against Webb? Will it be Rosano? Will it be Sandman? Will it be GQ Money? Or will it be chaos? And Lizzie Borden, of course, still suffering at the hands of that near fatal explosion, that accident that she had as world champion. Webb looks very focused, yet at the same time very concerned. XPW CEO Rob Black escorting his wife Lizzie Borden, still the very lovely Lizzie Borden. This, what her face must look like right now, and for her to be out of the house, it's remarkable. Webb now circling the ringside as World Heavyweight Champion. World Heavyweight Champion Webb now getting set for battle. He's going to be defending the World Heavyweight Championship, well, against, once again, a mystery opponent. Who it is, we don't know, but Webb, the world champ right now, circling the broadcast of Webb. Okay, thank you very much. Well, Webb, I think he's got to focus on his match and not focus on my broadcast calling and not focus, well, on Lizzie Borden, on Rob Black. He's got to focus right now. He doesn't know what to focus on. I don't know who he's going to focus on either. Maybe he's done his homework on all the Enterprise members. Who knows? Nonetheless, the XPW World title is on the line tonight at Night of Champions. Well, now we await the mystery opponent. Who it is, I don't know. Lizzie Borden. And yes, it's chaos. Big surprise. Yes, there he is, the world TV title holder. Chaos will be going against Webb. It's champion versus champion. The world title is on the line. Webb, Chaos. We'll battle it out for the undisputed XPW World Heavyweight title. Look at Chaos, still suffering from this last battle he had with the TV title match. Him and Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick. And folks, right now, we don't know the state of Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick, but when he landed along with Chaos, Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick, well, seriously injured. What is this? Wait just a minute. Oh, wait, Veronica Kane. Well, obviously, here she comes. And she obviously selected Chaos.
to be the challenger for the world title. I mean, I can't say that I blame her, because Chaos definitely having the credentials to take the title. But what is she doing here? What is this? And now Webb looks concerned. Veronica Kane saying,
I've been making phone calls, been spending a little time on the phone. Rob Black, you're not a very smart man to let me have my choice of Enterprise members. You didn't say current Enterprise members.
Current? What's she talking about?
I brought a legend. I brought a champion to be my champion.
A champion to be her champ? What is she talking about?
XPW fans, let's welcome the newest member of the Enterprise.
Who? Wait just a minute! Don't tell me he's back! Wait a minute. Oh. The franchise Shane Douglas! The franchise Shane Douglas! The franchise Shane Douglas is back at XPW! I can't believe it! The franchise is back at XPW! Shane Douglas, the franchise who put XPW on the map, is back! He's back, ladies and gentlemen! And he's obviously, apparently, the newest member of the E! Rob Black, he can't believe it. This was supposed to be Rob Black's big night. His big triumphant return.
Lizzie Borden and Rob Black. He is the current reigning and defending XPW World Heavyweight Champion. He is the king. He is accompanied to the ring by Enterprise members Veronica Kane and Chaos. He is from Pittsburgh, California, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the franchise, Shane Douglas!
The franchise, Shane Douglas, he is here at XPW. And he's going after Webb's XPW World Heavyweight title. I never would have ever thunk that I'd see the day that the franchise Shane Douglas will be back in XPW. The franchise Shane Douglas, yes, he is back. And look at this Webb. I can't believe it. Webb can't believe it. Look at the eyes. Look at Webb. I've never seen that look in his face before. Webb can't believe it. I can't believe it. These fans are in awe. The franchise, Shane Douglas, the man who put this company on the map, is back in XPW, and he's going after the World Heavyweight title.
And it looks like this match is about to get underway. Referee Patrick Hernandez now telling Shane Douglas he's got to watch his cast. Yes, he has a cast on his right forearm, and now this match is getting underway. Webb wants to go for a test of strength here. Shane Douglas. Oh, wait a minute. Correction. Test of stench. Webb's hand is soiled. It's soiled, ladies and gentlemen. And now the left hand as well. Both are soiled. Oh, look at this. Webb playing mind games. Going right after Shane Douglas. Double axe handle to the shoulder. Kicks now. A few of them to the midsection. And now shots right to the head. Fist as Shane Douglas backed up on the near side. Irish whip perhaps coming up. Yes. Shane Douglas to the far side. And look at the clothesline. And Shane Douglas goes down. But Webb, look at this. Webb may have hurt his knee. He's had some injuries in the past as far as his knee's concerned. And Webb has had a long reign, ladies and gentlemen, as XPW World Champion since August of 2001. He's beat Sabu. He's beat Vampiro. He's beat the Sandman. But this has got to be his toughest bout to date. And Shane Douglas now standoffish. He doesn't want to have anything to do with all the weaponry around the ring here for the Deathmatch Tournament. And Webb missing the dropkick. Shane just barely getting out of the way. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Shane Douglas now with Webb in a very compromising position. Shane Douglas, the man who can walk out of here tonight with the XPW title around his waist. What is this now? He's got the right leg. Oh, look at this. Working on the knee. The right knee of Webb. Apparently, maybe Shane Douglas saw Webb limping earlier with that injured left knee. Maybe now making sure Webb can't walk at all in this match. And Webb, this has got to be a big concern for Webb and the Black Army in the early goings of this match. Webb already looks like he's severely injured. Now Shane Douglas in control of the match, in control of the XPW World Heavyweight Champion Webb. Suplex, textbook style coming up perhaps. Yes, snap, textbook suplex. And look at that, look, Shane Douglas holding on. Another one, once again, two of them. And look at this, rolling step suplex again. Three times, look at the elevation, the blood rushing to the head of Webb. Three, four, 5 seconds, yes, and Webb goes crashing down right in the center of the ring. Going for the pin now, perhaps a little premature, one, two, only two. Senior official referee Patrick Hernandez right there to count, and look at this. Shane Douglas going for a chin lock now. Using the knee right to the back of Webb's neck, right to the external occipital protuberance area. Really wrenching away at the chin lock now, right in the center of the ring. Shane Douglas has got Webb right where he wants him, but Webb, oh. Webb trying to fight out, look at this. Counter now from Webb. And now Veronica Kane looks very concerned. Low blow onto Shane Douglas. Webb barely getting to his feet. Kick now to the midsection with that injured knee, mind you. But Webb, the champion that he is, still fighting. Going outside of the ring, right on top of the franchise, Shane Douglas. And look at this, one of these camera cable cords now choking away at Shane Douglas. And referee Patrick Hernandez right there, counting on the champ to break the hold ultimately. And Veronica Kane looking very concerned as well. And look at this, Webb. Whoa. Webb wants no part of Hernandez. He wants to keep his title, and you can hear the disapproval of the crowd. Look at this, Veronica Kane. Shane Douglas still conversing, the newest member. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've just joined us, the newest member of the Enterprise, the franchise, Shane Douglas, has returned to XPW. Oh, and look at this, Shane Douglas right into the ringsiders. Webb now following him up, yes. He's got a ringside chair right to the back of Shane Douglas. Looks like he's going to swing again, yes, right between the eyes. The sea of fans now huddling around. Clothesline from Webb onto Shane Douglas, and both these guys falling into the muck, into the dirt, into the sea of fans here in Southern California. XPW security team now trying to shoo everybody back. And I'm not talking about former Clipper head coach Gene Shue. Oh, look at that. Another chair shot right between the eyes from Shane Douglas onto Webb. Shane now with another chair. Yes, again. And Webb's out. Look at him. Stumbling, staggering about. Shane Douglas now in control. Three times right to the head of Webb. And look at this. Number four perhaps coming up. Yes. Oh, no. Webb with a counter. Beautiful counter that was. Desperation knee now to the midsection. Kick now to the midsection. Pounding away on the back. Webb, a house of fire. And look at this. The Boon Shoe perhaps coming into play. The karate chops as well. Now look at this, Webb with Shane Douglas right into that huge wall here at the arena. And look at this, the security railing tumbling down at the fans. And look at that, Webb right to the back of Shane Douglas with that chair once again. Both these guys still out on the arena floor, or should I say, the arena dirt. But now it's Webb with the upper hand, grabbing Shane Douglas. Oh, wait a minute. Right into the wall, and now Shane Douglas goes down right on top of that security railing that was knocked down by the sea of fans. Referee Hernandez now checking on Shane Douglas and all Veronica Kane looking very concerned right now. Her man, the one she chose from the E, the newest member, mind you, of the Enterprise to win the XPW World Heavyweight title. But Rob Black and Lizzie Borden at the ringside area too looking very concerned. Wait a minute, from behind, Shane Douglas up on top of the security railing. Webb doesn't know where he is or where Shane Douglas is for that matter. Look at this, Webb, turn around, Webb, Shane Douglas, high cross body, and Webb goes down. Up and over, Webb. Shane Douglas now with Webb right where he wants him, outside of the ring. But he's the only way to win the title is inside of the ring. Look at this now, oh no. Oh no, no, with the legs spread open, low blow. Low blow, Patrick Hernandez warning the franchise. Franchise picking up Webb now. Still on the arena floor, mind you. The franchise, look at this. Belly to back, no. Oh, crouches him right into that scaffold. That 40-foot high scaffold, and Webb is down. And that scaffold, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna be seeing utilized tonight, the final of the XPW King of the Deathmatch Tournament, as the hardcore homo Angel later tonight will be going against Supreme for the 2002 King of the Deathmatch Tournament winner. And ironically, Shane came into XPW originally back in February of 2000, back in the very first King of the Deathmatch Tournament, and now he returns in the third annual. Webb. Oh no, look at this, right into the windshield of that parked car here in Southern California at the arena. Look at Shane Douglas, look at him. Look at him, he wants the title. You can see it in his eyes, he's back. And Veronica King can smell the gold as well. Oh, look at that though, back body drop, up and over the hood, and onto the dirt. Oh, look at that. Look at the back of Shane Douglas cut by the windshield of that parked car. And these cars are literally here to be used as weapons in the Deathmatch Tournament, but they're being used as weapons here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, in the title match as well. Webb, down and out, but Shane Douglas has made it back to the squared circle with a back full of blood, ladies and gentlemen. What a laceration that is. Veronica Kane on the outside of the ring. Veronica Kane shoving Shane Douglas over to the champ, Webb. Shane Douglas picking Webb up now. Looks like he's gonna, yes, throw him back into the ring. Webb covered in dirt. Shane Douglas going upstairs, it looks like. Yes, Shane Douglas up top. But Webb trying with all his might to get to his feet. Oh, he stumbled right on top of the rope, but Shane Douglas still keeping his balance. Wait a minute. Webb, oh, slam. Shane Douglas from the top and on to the center of the ring. And that back is still lacerated from the windshield of the car, ladies and gentlemen. Blood is everywhere. Webb just slammed Shane Douglas on his back, on the injured back once again, where blood is just gouging out of the back itself. Now Shane Douglas with Webb, right where he wants him, Irish whip, yes, across the ropes, and look at this power slam. Webb goes down right in the center of the ring. Going for a pin perhaps. What is this, referee doubt? No. Oh, wait a minute. Wait, there's the cat. But why did he abandon the count? He might have had Webb pinned. Oh, look at this. The franchise loading up the cast now. Ready to utilize it on the champ. Look at his face. Pointing over, yes. Yes to Veronica Kane. What is this? Veronica Kane going into her. Oh, wait a minute, there's a chain. Deja vu all over again. And I'm not talking about where I was last Saturday night. Look at this. Veronica Kane, yes, handing the chain to Shane Douglas. That cast, the chain, both down. No, you got it. Oh, no, no. Webb pulled referee Patrick Hernandez right in front of him. The franchise nailed the ref. We have a major proportional problem here, ladies and gentlemen. Patrick Hernandez is out.
in the ringside area. We have no referee, but the title is still on the line. The chain now, about blocked now from Webb. Knee to the midsection, shot to the head. Irish whip coming up. Chain to the near side, to the midsection once again with that injured knee. That had to take its toll. Scoop up from Webb. Look at this, going for the TCB. No! Chain brought his feet down the blanket, but still, Webb got a little bit of it. Chain holding his wrist, going for the pin, but there's still no ref. Oh, wait a minute. The other referee coming to the ring now. Blondie, one. Only one. Both men in a tremendous amount of pain. Webb went for that TCB, but he didn't quite execute it 100%. Shane Douglas going to the near side, trying as hard as he can to get to his feet, to become the XPW World Heavyweight title with that laceration still. The blood pouring out of the back of Shane Douglas. Veronica Kane looking very nice, but also looking very, very concerned at the ringside area. Shane Douglas with Webb right in the palm of his hands. Going for Webb now. Slams him into the far side. Webb counters now with elbows to the face. Boots to the midsection. Shane still with the chain in hand, firing Shane Douglas into the turnbuckle. Forearm shots to the back now of the franchise. The franchise once again wailing his head away. Webb continuing to pound Shane Douglas's head into the turnbuckle, because you gotta remember, and now into the canvas, you gotta remember that this match means more than just the XPW World Heavyweight title. Remember, this is a loser leaves town match, but it's also for the title. Whoever loses the match, well, we'll have to leave town, ladies and gentlemen. Shane Douglas back up, going right after Webb. Shane Douglas, where did he get this from? Belly-to-belly suplex, yes. And Webb goes crashing down to the center of the ring. But the lot's been taken out of Shane Douglas. Very winded as well, barely getting over for the pin. One, two, and oh, was that close. That was so close, ladies and gentlemen. We were inches away from a brand new XPW World Champ. Shane Douglas now still barely staggering to his feet. Webb is down and out. How he kicked out of that, I don't know. But look at this. Shane, he's got the chain once again. And the referee saying no, no. Blondie over here saying step off. Obviously, this new ref saw what happened. The senior official, Patrick Hernandez, he doesn't want to. And look at this. The ref telling Shane he better ditch that chain right now. He's showing who's the ref in this match, because he wants this to be a clean bout. And look at this. Oh, wait a minute. No! No! That's blasphemy! That's blasphemy! Hitting an XPW official. Now two referees are down and out in this match. Webb trying to get to his feet. Headbutt to the groin. Webb picking Shane Douglas up. Spine buster. Going for the pin, but once again. Wait a minute. Referee number three. One, two. Oh, no. Only two. Felony, the ref, just barely made it to the ring, but it was only a two count. Webb, right there, inches away from retaining his title. And this is a seesaw battle, ladies and gentlemen. This match has gone back and forth. Webb, oh, look at that low blow. Webb falling back, ultimately kicking Shane right between the legs. Heel kick right to the back of the neck, trying to roll Shane up for a pin now. Yes, one, two, only two. Wait a minute, now Shane with Webb, one, two, only two again. Webb once again with the crucifix pin. No, look at this. This is back and forth, ladies and gentlemen. Shane with Webb, right where he wants him. Belly to belly. Is this going to do it? One, two, yes! Shane Douglas has won the XPW World Heavyweight Championship, and Webb's career is over. Webb must now leave town. And Shane Douglas leaves the arena with the title belt around his waist. And here comes Veronica Kane. Look at the face, of course, of Rob Black. You can't see the face of Lizzie Borden, but you can imagine what she's feeling right now. Veronica Kane, the Enterprise, is now sitting on the top of the world. Veronica Kane ready to hand. Yes, that man right there, the franchise, Shane Douglas. The XPW World Heavyweight title, I still can't believe it, ladies and gentlemen. For one, the return of the franchise, and two, we have a new champion. What the hell? Shane Douglas just headbutted Veronica Kane. What is this? What did she do? Wait a minute. Pittsburgh Plunge coming up. Shane Douglas, the new champ. Oh, no. What the hell's going on? It's crazy. Wait a minute. Don't tell me. Are they together on this? Rob Black laughing. Shane Douglas laughing. And Lindsay Borden. Well, I can't tell. But look at that. No. I can't believe it. What the hell? I'm going nuts. Shane Douglas just turned on Kane and then Rob Black. Lindsay Borden. Wait a minute. With the belt. No, once again, right between the eyes. Very standoffish now, Lindsay Borden. She better watch out. Shane Douglas with the title. What the hell is Dorco Dude doing out here? Kevin Kleinrock, Vice President of Operations here in Extreme Professional Wrestling, and what's in the briefcase? And Kevin Kleinrock, I don't know if he didn't just see what happened. He's very calm right now, despite all the carnage and all the mayhem we just witnessed here at Night of Champions. Shane Douglas laid out Kane, laid out Rob Black, and now Lindsay Borden, you better watch out. He's gonna lay you out too. What is this? The mask is off. What the? Ah! There's nothing wrong with her face at all. What is going on? What the hell is going on?
Hey, you. You piece of shit.
A divorce! I can't believe this.
Kevin, this shouldn't have been made possible without you, my friend. Look at your Rob Black, who brought you XPW, who you sat up there and cheered for and rallied behind and paid your hard-earned greenbacks to support. Well, he's laying in a bloody piece of shit because the franchise just franchised his ass.
I don't know what to make of this. What the hell? What the hell can happen, Daddy?
Put your hands on me. We are taking this company back to where they know what wrestling is. Back to the East Coast. And you, California, pieces of can wave XPW goodbye. August 31st, the guy who made ECW Extreme makes the ECW arena XPW's new home, the XPW arena. Now hit my f***ing music.
The franchise, Shane Douglas, the new XPW World Heavyweight Champion, is bringing XPW to the old ECW arena August 31st. In Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, as we see the new XPW World Heavyweight title belt around the waist. Oh my goodness, look at this. Shane Douglas, the new champion, along with Lindsay Borden, turning his back on Rob Black. But first it was Black that turned his back on Webb. Then Kevin Kleinrock turned his back on Black, and then the franchise turned his back on Shane. Damn it, I don't know what the hell's going on. All I can say is Shane Douglas is now the new world champion. Rob Black, an apparent divorce with Lindsay Borden.
But we have a new champion. It's the franchise, Shane Douglas. And there's going to be no more.
No more Webb. As he just lost the Loser Leaves Town match, he's gone from XPW. More than just the title he lost. Oh, wait a minute, XPW security rushing over. We got some livid fans. We got some pissed off fans here in the arena. They just found out that XPW is gone. Vominos from Los Angeles, California, and it's found its new home in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Folks, that's all I can tell you. All I know is we have a brand new XPW World Heavyweight Champion in the franchise, Shane Douglas, and we have a new home. XPW has a new home, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Rob Black down, Veronica Kane down. Where does this leave Kane? Where does this leave Black? Ultimately, where does this leave XPW? So many lives change in this match as Webb walks off for the final time out of an XPW arena show. His career is now over. Rob Black down and out. XPW, where the hell do we stand? So many lives, so many careers, all changed in just one match. In the finals of the third annual XPW King of the Deathmatch tournament, and he's going to be going against the man who won it in the beginning. He's going to be going against Supreme. Angel eyeing that scaffold, eyeing the weapons, eyeing the explosives as we eye the belt. The XPW King of the Deathmatch title, yes. Referee Patrick Hernandez in the ring. And there goes Angel. Angel now, here for his matchup. He looks focused. He looks ready. He's come a long way to be in this tournament. And it doesn't look like he's fearing Supreme at all. You got to remember, he got by GQ Money, then he got by the Impossible, he got by Pogo the Clown, but now he's got to get by Supreme if he wants to do the Impossible. And here comes the original King of the Deathmatch. Supreme! Now Supreme's eyeing the scaffold, as he's also eyeing all the weaponry around the ring. Right now, folks, join me in a prayer of your own for both these men. These men need a prayer right now. This could be career ending, and I hate to say it, this could be life ending. Angel. Geared up, Supreme. Supreme knows what it is to be the XPW King of the Deathmatch. He wants this title more than anything, more than life itself. He's gonna have to get through Angel though. All the explosives around the ringside area.
Angel! opponent from Hollywood, California. He is the human horror film. He is Supreme.
The match is officially underway. Supreme, Angel, the King of the Deathmatch.
I don't know if you're
to be determined
boss.
Right now. But Ron Head, we've all already said a prayer for both of these men.
Baruch atah Adonai, in the name of the Father, the Son, and everything that matters.
Supreme with the first shot in this match, going right after Angel, the hardcore homo. Now, look at this Irish whip to the far side. Oh, into that bed of nails.
Already into that bed of rusty, sharp nails.
Hopefully he's had his tetanus shot. Look at this. One more time.
Yeah,
yes.
Kinda...
Angel, once again, huge clothesline, Supreme Bowman. And look at that scaffold. Look at the size of that thing.
That is a gargantuan structure.
It takes your breath away, doesn't it, Ron Head?
My breath's already been gone many times tonight, and this is not helping matters at all.
Look at this now, Supreme. No, already, you got to be kidding me. Look at this. Oh, yeah, he's pointing. The bed of light bulb. Angel.
A head and arm suplex into the fluorescent light detonators.
Angel right away in the early stages of this match. No, again, you got to be kidding me.
Again.
Angel twice, and Supreme is relentless.
Well past midnight, the fans are erupting with XPW chants. Every one of them knows a near-death experience might happen. Chris Kloss, Angel is not moving, and Supreme perching the barbed wire board dead center of the deathmatch ring.
And now look at this. Yes, you can see Angel, the pain expression on his face. I mean, twice. Look, he's crying. He's crying. And you can't blame him. I mean, being put through a bed of fluorescent light bulbs, a stiff shot from Supreme. Angel still suffering at the hands. And now, yes, you're right, Ron Head, the bed of barbed wire about to be utilized in this match. Powerbomb, yes, coming up. No, Angel firing back. Look at this. Oh, face buster. Face buster into the barbed wire.
Supreme, face first. He's going to be a bloody mess, and they still have yet to make their way into the scaffold ring that's wired to explode.
And you know, you've got to remember, there is no submission, there is no pinfall in this match. The man who wins is the man who throws his opponent off of the scaffold and down. And like you said, it's wired to explode tonight.
What price do these athletes put themselves through to win the XPW King of the Deathmatch tournament, to get that title, to win the tournament? At what stake? Maybe their safety, maybe their careers, maybe their damn lives.
Supreme, a bloody mess now. Has Angel right where he wants him. Look at this suplex, perhaps, coming up. No, Angel blocking it. Look at this. Angel blocking twice. Angel now with Supreme, or is it Supreme with Angel?
Look at this.
Table. Oh, no. Shoulder block. Look at that table of barbed wire. No way. Oh, look at that.
A sunset bomb onto the barbed wire table to the floor. Angel has more guts than anyone has given him credit for, Chris Kloss.
And look at this. A sunset flip into a powerbomb indeed. Oh, look at the face of Supreme. Look at the blood flowing down the face. And now Angel. Angel with the upper hand after that powerbomb into the table with barbed wire.
Can you imagine the pain they're going through?
Oh, no. Look at this. Angel. No.
Right onto the body of Supreme.
Look at this now. Oh! Light bulb right between the eyes. The bloodied already face of Supreme.
Glass is being driven into the face of Supreme. And now a wiffle ball bat with thumbtacks.
Oh, no,
crazy glued.
Oh, look at that. Crazy glued onto the wiffle ball thumbtacks. And look at this. The already bloodied Supreme. You got to be kidding me. This guy's
lost so much
blood already.
That's plastic, but that's thumbtacks crazy glued on there, and
Supreme now, a bloody mess.
Look at this now! Oh no! What is this? No!
With the extension handle! With an extension handle for more momentum!
Look at this now!
And now the ringside area now with that dust from inside, the toxic fumes from inside those fluorescent light detonators, and now a structure!
And I'm coughing in
this smoke! Oh, that's
smoke.
A nasty tasting vapor!
And this is toxic! This is toxic now, Rodhead, settle down! Look at Supreme! What does he have in mind now? He's got that huge... Oh no! Look at this! Supreme! Supreme, come on, open your eyes, Rodhead! Open your eyes!
I can't help it, I got that crap all inside my eyes here!
Look at this! Oh my God! Oh my God!
The hardcore homo is taking a beating like never before!
Look at this, did you see? The glass, the light bulb, right over the back of Angel!
No bathhouse rendezvous has ever been as painful as this. The beating that Supreme is laying on Angel is unmerciless.
And look at this, Supreme with a ladder now. Tossing a ladder out to the ringside area.
And they still have yet to make their way into the ring.
And these fans on their feet. Look at this now, another light bulb over the back of Supreme.
I've already lost count of how many.
Oh, look at that. Right into that car door. Tony T's got to be hating life right now. Oh, look at this shot.
Tony T, Supreme, and Angel, they're putting themselves through incredible agony here.
Once again, Tony T parking his car in the wrong spot today. International Talent Scout, look at this Angel now coming over to the ring.
Look at
to ring number one. And look at your right run head. Look at the face of Supreme. You can see the blood. Oh, that's just sick.
I don't care what you say. Double, triple, double.
Wait,
they're going to climb.
Angel. Angel's going up the scaffold.
Up to the heavens goes Angel.
And listen to the fans here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena, thousands of them.
Well past midnight here, not one fan is left and not one fan is seated. A near-death experience is about to happen.
Look at this Angel going up to the top, going up to the top of the scaffold with a steel chair. But it's Supreme pointing up now. And yes, look at this, Supreme following him up.
Angel already well over 30 feet high above the ring. Hardcore wrestling is one thing. We are about to witness someone possibly and alive here. I hate to say it. I don't want to see it, but it just might happen.
Supreme going up now. Ron Head, once again, you got to be a very lonely man. And look at this, Supreme. And yes, Angel's on the scaffold. Angel's up on top. And look at this whole thing is teetering. This whole thing is shaking right now. But Supreme!
Totally unstable here.
Totally unstable! And Supreme has the... But yes, now he's up there! Supreme! Angel both up top!
Angel with wings, not afraid to fly. Supreme is down on the scaffold. And Angel is getting ready to put away the human horror film. I hate to say it, Klaus, this may not just be a wrestling match. It just might turn into a snuff video.
Look at this now. Angel, never in the history of professional wrestling.
Wrestling, it's not even wrestling anymore. A life may end before our eyes here.
And now look at this, with a steel chair. Yes, right on the head of Supreme. Angel with the upper hand now. On the scaffold, on the 40-foot scaffold. And remember now, all the tables below in the center of the ring.
Supreme.
Wait a minute, Franchise, what the hell is Shane Douglas doing out here? And what the hell does he have? What is that? Angel? Angel's grabbing his neck. What is that, a tranquilizer?
Tranquilizer a gun into the throat of Angel.
What was that?
Clutching at the throat.
What was that, Angel? Angel's stumbling. He fired again. Franchise fired again. But it's Angel. Angel's teetering. Oh, no. Oh. Holy f***ing Supreme! Supreme! Supreme has won it! Supreme has done the impossible! But it was Shane Douglas who apparently shot Angel with a pellet gun!
and they're obviously with some sort of fluid, some sort of tranquilizer. And Angel went crashing down 40 feet into the scaffold, and Supreme is climbing down the scaffold, and he is the XPW Undisputed King of the Deathmatch.